Afternoon, everybody. Thank you for joining me. Yesterday, there was an earthquake in the Los Angeles area, a magnitude 4.3, and here's the spectrogram as it came in at Santa Catalina Island. The only monitor that I've been able to find after hours of searching for that location, and I'll show you the signature as it came in. Using Google Earth, here's the monitor. And there was other earthquakes, and I want to show you the area of that earthquake. Down here we have the port of Los Angeles. And they are reporting three earthquakes in this area, the largest being the 4.3. We also more recently had a 1.4, and there was also a 3.0. This is along a fault line or near a fault line that has thrust earthquakes. Very dangerous, and I've been covering this area in the past. Here we have the Newport Inglewood fault zone, and this area is overdue and is capable of having very large earthquakes. There is another monitor, but I can't seem to get the data to upload to my swarm view. This fault zone is what they call a thrust fault zone. Thrust earthquakes are the worst you can have. Thrust earthquakes are when one fault line drops down, the other one rises up. And those that follow me will remember when I talked about when you have a large earthquake, you'll be shot up into the air like on a seesaw, maybe 30 feet. And that's if and when you have a large earthquake in this location. It'll be like an arrow being shot into the air. On the USGS Did You Feel It webpage, 10,037 people reportedly said they felt the earthquake. And we'll show you the moment tensorball. Yeah, this was a thrust earthquake. Yeah, where one side of the fault drops down, the other side raises up. First wave of the earthquake came from the north. Tension was applied. Oh, going east a little bit. On the felt reports, here's the locations of all those people that felt the 4.3. Yeah, San Luis Obispo, going all the way down to the border of Mexicali and San Diego and Tijuana. There's been other earthquakes, and you can see them here all marked in red. So this 4.3 occurred at 7:58 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Just before 8 o'clock. Just a few minutes later, there was a magnitude 1.4. 12 people said they felt that earthquake. And then, at 11:06 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, there was a magnitude 3.0. And let's go to the moment tensorball. This one was a strike slip. You can see the fault line moved southwest, dipping. Yeah, towards the south. There's the signature as it came in at Catalina Island. Yep, and like I said, there's been other little ones. A lot of these are just traffic, things that occurred there on the island. This one probably wasn't. This was an earthquake. It recorded there at 1907. They don't report it, so I don't know where it occurred. See, it's different than these other signatures. And then this one here at 6:06. Now that's the 3.3. And I'll give you an example. See how there's like it starts out small and gets large? That's probably noise. But this one does not have that. And this one's an iffy right there, which was at 23 minutes after midnight. And just kind of looking through them here. Yeah, I don't know what was going on there. Some kind of noise. But see that one right there? Yeah, that is not an earthquake. That one probably is at 1907. This one there, that's an iffy, 2219. I need another monitor to really see. But see how it's got that little signature before it? This one is definitely an earthquake. Like I said, I keep showing you that one. These are not earthquakes, and this is what it's showing right now. the monitor is at the airport. I don't know how much air traffic they're getting. There is a little one right there. A little tiny thing. That's an iffy too. There's a Twitter post by Fault Whisper about this earthquake and how it's got a very long seismic wave on it. Yeah, it did. Here, this is from the stream view. See, this is noise. Let me go back another couple hours here and show you some other examples. And maybe I'll... Okay, that's an actual earthquake. That's the one at 6:06. And we'll go back another 2 hours. And this is that signature. Can you see it over there as it came in? And it stretches, yeah, really long seismic wave. Before this earthquake, there was some very small ones. Let me show you on the stream view. That's them right there. I'll highlight it. And let's extract that. See, that's not noise. Got another small earthquake before that at 1919. See that? And see this? This is noise. Let me close this for you. That's noise. That's noise. That's noise. That's probably noise. This one up here isn't. Let me extract that one for you. 1417. Yeah, not being reported. And possibly another one right there at 1538. Yeah, these would probably be little microquakes. And as you know, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for something much larger to come. So, did you feel this earthquake? Are you prepared to be shot like an arrow from a thrust earthquake that is overdue for this area? If you did feel this earthquake, please put those comments down below. How long did it last? What did it feel like? Did you have damage? How did your pets react? Yeah, we're all curious about that information. What did it sound like? Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.